This video is brought to you by Storyblocks Video.
No, we're not doing that. Come on.
No, we're not doing... Come on, guys, come on. No, no, we're not doing the disintegration effect.
Stop doing that.
No, we're not doing the disintegration effect. Come on, you guys have been asking for this for an entire year now. No, get away.
Disintegration effect, what was...
No, guys, come on, stop. No, we're not doing the disintegration effect. What is wrong with all of you? No! All right, you win. Janek, get over here. We're doing the disintegration effect. Hey guys, it's Jordy here for CineCam.net, and welcome to Copycat Friday, the weekly series in which we recreate effects from famous films and music videos. And since the first Infinity Wars film got out, we've been getting so many comments from you guys asking us to create that disintegration effect. Now personally, I never wanted to do it because there are already some great tutorials out there that I think show the effect really great. And I think the ones from Production Crate and Film Learning really stand out. And I just don't want to make a copy of them, so we're gonna do it a little bit different today. Everyone is using a third-party plugin called Trapcoat. Now it does cost some money, and although it's worth every penny, we are gonna do it without. The only thing that we're gonna need is Adobe After Effects. Now one problem that we were running into was the motion of the particles, and I strongly believe that we can never get it perfect without Trapcoat. So we did make a disintegration effect that is fairly simple to make, however, it's not exactly the same as in the film. But I think for everyone who is starting out with Adobe After Effects, this tutorial right here is definitely gonna tackle some very nice techniques. Hey Janek, when you're done cleaning up here, could you help me out? I'm trying to create this effect, but I just can't get it to work.
Sure.
Ah, thanks Janek. Oh yeah, before I forget, have you seen Lorenzo somewhere?
Did you check the toilet?
No, I haven't yet. You know, there's this pile of dust somewhere and I want him to clean it up, but I just can't find him anywheres. I'll check the toilet. Thanks, Janek. Jordy! Well, guess I'll just do all the work around here. Where is Janek now? First Lorenzo is gone, now Janek is gone. And what's with all the ashes around the office here? Anyways, let's take a quick moment to thank our sponsor, Storyblocks Video, today. With Storyblocks Video, you got access to unlimited video assets going from backgrounds, transitions, video effects, After Effects templates, high-quality studio stock clips in 4K resolution, and so much more. And the cool thing is that there's only a single price per year, and without additional fees, you can download the entire library if you like so. We use it on a daily basis and can highly recommend to use it as well. Definitely check it out by clicking the first link in the description below. And now let's mop the floor a little bit further. Now to make your shots, you are gonna need to shoot yourself against a green screen. Now we actually did a tutorial a few weeks ago on how to pull the perfect green key, so definitely check that out, I'll leave a link to it in the description below. Also take an empty shot when you're done and make sure that both of the shots were done from a tripod. That's it, and then bring the two shots into Adobe After Effects. Place your empty shot on the bottom and the green screen shot on top. With the pen tool, you want to draw on the inside of the green screen to get rid of the rest. Finally, search for the key light effect in your effects library, and we're gonna grab that key light preset that also has a cleaner and a spill light remover. Again, I'm pointing to our in-depth video about green screens where I show exactly how to get the best results with this key light effect. Then after you've picked the green, it'll be keyed out, which is gonna make sure that your background and the talent is gonna be in a separate layer, and that is exactly what we want. Now, we're about to work with an effect that is not super stable. We've had After Effects crash several times, so there are a few things we have to take in account. First of all, make sure that you're working on 1080p footage. The effect can't handle 4K, unfortunately. Now, if you're doing a green key, I would first do that in 4K and then export it to 1080 to do the rest. The second thing is that you want to have your renderer set to full at all time. Don't ask me why, that's just how Adobe works.
All right, we can now go ahead and duplicate the shot of the talent. This duplication is gonna be the effect where your talent turns into brown ashes, not the actual particles yet. On this duplication, we're gonna add a fractal noise. Change the brightness and contrast so that you get a nice contrast pattern, as you can see right here. After that, add a tint effect to it as well and map the white color to something brownish, the color of the ashes. Finally, add a linear wipe to the clip. We're gonna use this to reveal the layer. Start by animating the transition completion from 1 to 0. Now, the speed of this animation will define the speed of the disintegration as well. When you're done, change the angle the way you want. Of course, where you see this layer appear first will also define the start of the disintegration. And finally, add some feather to that linear wipe to top it off. And this is what the complete animation should look like. All right, we can now go ahead and select the two layers, right-click and choose Pre-compose to group them together. On this composition, we are going to add the effect called Shatter. And this is that very unstable effect that I was talking about. I really hope that Adobe will update this effect one day to be more compatible with modern hardware. But anyways, let's have a look at it. For starters, we're going to change the view to renderer so that we can actually see what we're doing. For the pattern, select glass, which is going to give us the right texture. Next, increase the repetitions to around 200, and this will define the amount of particles. Extrusion depth is going to be to 0, as we don't want a three-dimensional particle. Next, head on to the force. The position property is going to shatter your clip, so we're going to position that one above the starting point, where we also let the linear wipe start. The radius defines the radius of that position point. In the beginning, it has to be small, so that we don't see the shatter yet. And then comes the strength. This defines how much the particles will explode. We're gonna set this to around 0.2, since the disintegration will gently shatter and not explode. Alright, now jump into the physics. The rotation speed can be set to the max, together with the randomness. And this will let the particles flow more organic as they break apart. The viscosity, if I pronounce that right, can be increased to around 0.2. Now this will keep the particles more together, and we'll get back to this one in a moment. The ashes of the disintegration is something very lightweight, so we're gonna decrease the gravity to around 0.2. Eventually, the ashes will move away, and you can define which direction they have to go to with the gravity direction. Setting it to 0 will make them go upwards. And finally is the gravity inclination. You can kind of see this as the ramping of the gravity. We're increasing this to 50, which will first break the particles apart, and then it will slowly rise. Kind of the same thing as setting an ease to a keyframe. Alright, those were all the settings. We can now go ahead and make the animation, which actually goes very simple with this effect. We don't need to create any mask or anything like that. I'm going to create a keyframe for the position, radius, viscosity, and gravity. Then move forward in time, try to follow your previous linear wipe animation. And now change the position to go over your talent, and at the same time, increase the radius so that it shatters everything that comes in its path. Finally, decrease the viscosity to 0 so that the particles will move a little bit more apart, and increase the gravity to around 0.6 to make the particles go up faster over time. And when you got this right, you already have yourself a disintegration effect. But of course, we can make it look better. So the next steps are gonna be some fine-tuning. For starters, we're gonna add some fine dust to the effect. To do that, we are going to create a new solid. Make sure that it is a black solid. On this new layer, we're going to add the Add Grain effect. Change the viewing mode to Final Output, and then jump into the tweaking, where you wanna increase the intensity and the size to 10. And then decrease the softness to around 0.02, and this will give you some very nice sharp grain. Now under Color, we're going to check Monochromatic, and for the animation speed, set that one to 0, because we don't want the grain to move around. Now those who are wondering why we didn't simply use the noise effect to create this pattern, well, that's because we couldn't disable the animation of the grain with the noise effect. Alright, so this is gonna be the fine dust, but we're gonna use that layer as a pattern, so we can now go ahead and disable the layer output. Next, we're going to duplicate the layer on which we've created that first disintegration effect. Make sure that it is on the top of your edits. And this also copied the entire shatter effect with it, including the animation keyframes. Now, important is that you're gonna move your playhead on top of the first keyframes of this layer. From this point, we can now change a few settings from within, and those keyframes will automatically be updated. For starters, change the pattern to custom, and from the custom shader map below, we're going to point to that solid with the grain onto it. Make sure you also select effects and masks from the dropdown next to it. The shader effect will now use that grain for the texture of its dust. We're going to add a little bit of depth to this dust, so change the extrusion depth to 0.05. Then jump into the viscosity property and decrease that to 0.15. And this will make them spread a little bit more since the smaller dust is a lot more lightweight. The gravity can be increased a little to 0.4. Again, finer dust is more lightweight, so it has to race quicker. And finally is the gravity inclination, which defines the start animation of the gravity. In other words, an ease on a keyframe. Now decrease that to 40 so that the finer dust flies up quicker. And that's it. The last step is to animate one property different. So move your playhead to the last batch of keyframes. We're gonna update the gravity to a little bit more than what's currently set. This is to add an extra acceleration to the motion of the fine dust. And that's it. Wow, that was pretty intense, I know. But you've just created the disintegration effect from Thanos without any third-party plugins. Now, optional, you could add one last element to fine-tune the effect even more. Now, we are going to use a stock smoke clip. And you can find these on Storyblocks, for example, but I will also provide one that everyone can download from a link in the description. Now, this is a smoke clip that we've shot ourselves in the studio here. We've actually created an entire action element spec, which we're going to give more information about very soon. So import this clip into Adobe After Effects and place it in between the two shatter clips. Then change its blending mode to screen and reposition and scale the clip so that it sits behind the talent. We're gonna animate the position and the scale to make it follow the disintegration. From the first disintegration layer, you can go ahead and copy the tint effect, then paste it on the smoke to bring it into the same style, and that's it.
Darty!
Wow, we're really killing it lately with these long tutorials. But this one was on you. I don't want to hear any begging for the disintegration effect anymore as of now. All right? Good. Thank you so much for watching, guys. Thank you, Storyblocks, for the support. And as always, stay creative.
Panic. When you're done cleaning up here, can you come help me out with an After Effects effect? I can get it to work. Oh yeah! Before I forget, have you seen Lorenzo somewhere? There's this pile of ash, but I